Okay, I haven't done a video in a little while, so I'm gonna do a video about some rust removal. As you can see, this is the second round of barber chair that I am redoing, and as you can see, obviously it still has some rust along here, not as much over here. Right now it's got I just bought some Loctite brand navel jelly. It doesn't matter what brand, but the navel jelly works really well. I've used vinegar. Vinegar is, it works well. It's a nice solution if you just got like one or two pieces you want to soak overnight or something. It works great. It's real cheap. But if you got to do a bigger project, it becomes a pain in the ass when you got to, do all this stuff. Like I said, this is only one round, and all this stuff was completely covered in rust. So right now, what I'm going to do is, this is the foot pedestal, and as you can see, it's completely covered in rust, and this is basically what the rest of the stuff looked like. So I'm going to start simply. I bought some generic steel pads, whatever, wool pads, SOS, whatever, it doesn't matter. I don't think it really matters what kind of water you use, whether warm or cold, but even though you're trying to get rid of rust, believe it or not, what you want to do is get it nice and wet. Okay, I just use warm water so that my hand can be nice and comfortable, and just give it a pretty good scrubbing, just like you would washing the dishes. I usually keep this little extra bucket here, dip it every once in a while just so it's not, overly dry here. And really, what I'm doing is, I'm getting obviously the surface rust off, but basically what I'm really doing is I'm kind of creating a new surface for the navel jelly to get into, and taking off all the easy stuff so I don't have to waste navel jelly. Okay, now this is obviously a whole huge piece, and unfortunately I can't take it apart because I don't have any tools here right now. All my tools are at the shop and at the barn, so I really can't do much as far as that right now. But okay, as you can see, I'm just giving it a real good, well, I say real good, but as you can see, I'm going really fast with some cheap wool. But I just want to get everything a quick once over. You can scrub it as well as you want, but really just wasting elbow grease if you keep scrubbing for no reason. Because really this stuff's gonna kind of do the job for you. A good two times will get most of it gone. Third time will, release the rest. I would say, usually within three times you're fine. And navel jelly only takes about 5 to 10 minutes, so. Alright, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to finish rinsing this thing off, and then I'm going to dry it off. Alright, now as you can see, I gave it a pretty good drying. I hit it with the hairdryer real quick, but that's only because I really don't like too much big puddles of water. But it really, I dry it obviously, but I haven't had any problems with it being wet or anything. Now, this stuff says to make sure you watch contact with your skin and eyes. Eyes, obviously. And skin also, but I found that if I get it on my skin, as long as I wipe it off immediately and or wash it off, I really haven't had any problems. So, be cautious. I'm not responsible if you hurt yourself. But, overall, I really haven't had any problems as long as I've just taken care. Obviously, I know I'm going to get comments on how I have not disconnected these two pieces. Like I said, I do not have any tools right now, so I'm going to have to do it when I get back to the shop, and I will have to hit it with the Dremel. But as you can see, I just take this navel jelly and give it a really good coating, and you will find that it says 5 to 10 minutes. On heavy rust like this, I wait 15 minutes. Basically says how you don't want it to dry. So as soon as I see it starting to dry is when I either will give it an extra coat while it still has some on it, or I'll just start the next process, which is just scrubbing it down again. And so I mean, I'm gonna finish adding the rest of this and covering it and everything, and then I'll be back. Okay, and as you can see, I have not finished here. I haven't even started up here. I just wanted to show how this will focus. Okay, you can already see right here it started to remove. Just a minute ago it was completely covered. And as you can see, it's already starting to come off. I have not even finished putting it on. As you can see, he put it on liberally. Not political, just put a lot on. Okay, focus, focus, there we go. As you can see, I covered it. I had a lot of cracks, so I try to fill it in nice. Cost me about $6 for the thing at an expensive place, so I would say it normally costs you like $5 for, container. I don't know. That's my hand, so I don't know what's in here, 8 ounces. Now it says wait 5 to 10 minutes. Like I said, I like to wait about 10 to 15 minutes. But so in the meantime, I'm gonna finish these off. As you can see, a lot cleaner than this is. And this has already started to work. You can see it kinda, I mean, it kind of foams up, but in general, you can just see it's all breaking away. All right, so I'll be back in a couple of minutes. All right, unfortunately, my battery's about to die, so I'm gonna do pretty much gonna be ending the video, but basically, get a little bit of warm water here. That's why I like to do it, so I can handle it. It says to just rinse it with water, but as you can see, when you do this, it seems to work a lot better. Look at that. That's not all rust. Some of that's just discoloration from when it used to be nickel. As you can see on the top, all the rust is gone. That's only one time. I usually hit it two, sometimes three times. Look at that. Much improved first shot. As you can see, as I dry it, the surface rust comes back. That's just one coat. And I like to give it a little dry dry. Get a tiny bit on my arm. Burns for a quick second there, but like I said, it's just rinse immediately if you get it on yourself. But that's one time, and that was completely rusted. Now, some of this is pitting from, this is a 1910, 1920 barber chair foot pedestal, so don't expect this thing to come out looking fantastic, but I'll tell you what, without a sandblast for one time, it looks pretty good. So I'm going to keep going. I don't know how much battery life I got left, but this might be the end of the video. But as you can see, naval jelly. All right. Now, I don't know how the lighting looks, but and through the camera, it looks like surface rust, but there we go. As you can see, there's still some surface rust through here. But overall, what I could touch with the Brillo came off really nice. That's only a first coat. Been about 5 minutes. You can see everything working. Try to make sure I filled in every little crack. Same thing over here. It's important to try not to miss anything. And make sure your pets don't get to it. Okay, it's been, I don't know, maybe 10 minutes through. And I like to just give it a little touch up, kind of mix it around. You don't really have to add too much more. I just kind of like to mix it around. That way any air bubbles that popped up, you know, if there's an air bubble, it's probably not removing rust. So if I can move it around, so there's no longer an air bubble in that same spot, I would assume that it would work a little bit better. And so, as you can see, all the cracks are filled, but I'm basically just rubbing it kind of all over. Now, this is two times around, and I did all this other stuff already. As you can see, real clean. So that 8 ounce jar goes pretty far. So you can get a good idea of what it'll take to do your project. This is cast iron, in case anybody is wondering. This is not steel. As far as I know, should work on all hard metals. Aluminum, I would assume it would discolor it, but not hurt it necessarily. But steel, iron, you know, should be no problem with this stuff. I don't really see it harming any metal, to be honest. I just see it discoloring certain ones. So if you don't like that look, then don't do it. The other thing is, as soon as you are done doing this, what you're going to want to do is either clear coat it or paint it. Because if you do not, it will surface rust probably within a couple of days. Or I should say, actually, probably within about 24 hours. Okay, so next step will be to give it a scrub again. All right, here she goes. Believe it or not, it's probably be enough for it. Look at that. Just some warm water. Hopefully I don't get on dishes and get the wife mad. My wife mad. Like I said, my wife mad. My wife mad. She doesn't get mad often, I'm just saying. My wife, not the wife. Look at that. Beautiful! I haven't even scrubbed it. Yeah, water, as you can see, has got a little bit of steam to it, but I don't think it necessarily matters too much. I'm sure warmer water would help, but I don't think it has to be hot. Mm. give her a quick scrub. Alright, there she is. With the light focusing, you can see there's no more rust. I wouldn't say no more. Little shadows like here and here. It's just two times. I mean, tell you what, you're running a third time. That's the lighting. There we go. There you go, navel jelly, elbow grease. Thanks for watching. Like, comment, subscribe. I don't know. Talk shit. I don't really care.